They told him he's not old enough, not smart enough, but he did it anyway. I have another inspiring Power BI story for you about pursuing your dreams and overcoming obstacles and naysayers. Meet Tayer Atmane from Jordan, who founded and now runs the premier Power BI training institution there and is also the founder of the Jordan Power BI user group. My favorite part is the last question where I ask Tayer what motivates him in running his own business and pursuing his dreams, because I know it's not always easy. And his answer touched my heart. It's stories like Tayer that get me excited, stories from real people just like you and me, using Power BI to make a real impact. These are the Power BI pioneers. Do you have a story that could inspire others? Leave a comment and share that with us. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you are notified whenever I go live to help you in your Power BI journey. Let's hear it from Tayer.
Hey Tayer, how are you doing, my friend?
Hi, I'm fine. How are you?
So, great, I'm doing great. So you're talking to me from Jordan. Power BI in Jordan, is it really happening?
Actually, it is. Recently, it is. I found my own company as a training provider company. Yeah. So when I know about the Power BI, first step I joined your online course, which is
awesome.
Amazing, by the way.
Thank
it's
you.
Really awesome.
Good to have you in the program. Yeah.
Actually, your course was the first step for me to see how much Power BI can do. What's the capabilities for Power BI? Personally, I see that these capabilities can solve too many business needs mm-hmm. or too many business issues yeah. we currently have. So I adapt the idea and yeah. I focused in my company to market the Power BI. To be honest with you, I yeah. accessed many, many companies. It was the first time for them to hear yeah. about something called Microsoft Power BI.
Interesting.
But I'm so proud. Yeah. I'm so proud to introduce the Power BI for them. It was shocking for most of them. And let's face it, there is some clients see that I don't need this. It's like Excel, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's true.
But most of the clients see of, wow, what's that? Okay. Let's get into Power BI.
Yeah.
So we start a couple of courses like coaching, one-to-one service we provide, and it's moving very well. Actually, I'm seeing that within, let's say, 2 years maximum, I see we will have a very big boom for Power BI in our market.
Wow. So
it's really, really magical tool.
I couldn't agree with you more, but
I'm
looking at you and it feels to me like you're going to position yourself as the leader in Jordan and maybe in that kind of region as, you know, one of the pioneers for Power BI, right? I mean, people would be looking.
Well, I hope so. Okay, yeah, hope so. And right. I'm working on that. And it's worth to say that we are the only training provider in Jordan. The one and only and the first one. We are teaching and coaching on Power BI.
That is really interesting. I'm really fascinated by that. And I want to ask you to dig a little bit deeper. So the dynamic that I have is that, I mean, for one, it's odd, right? So you go to the Microsoft Summit, I call it the Power BI Summit, and there it feels like the world is on fire. Everybody's adopting Power BI. But then I realized it's a very self-selected crowd. Once you step beyond that, there are people like Power Who, you know? It's so sometimes I'm kind of torn. I'm like, should I focus on teaching Power BI to you know, kind of spread awareness? Or once they've found Power BI, do I help them there? But clearly it seems your work is cut out. I mean, given where things are kind of in that region with the industries that you work with, you have to kind of make them aware first. You have to, tell them what it is, how it can be helpful. But it seems that some people kind of get it, some people don't. And I've seen the same dynamic. And of course, working for yourself, being a consultant or independent company, you know, you get to choose. I mean, you can just move on, right? If somebody's not convinced, I can say, all right, man, good for you. You know,
whatever.
Stay with Excel. Exactly. Now, if you're stuck in a company, it can be very frustrating. You're trying to, you know, convince your boss. But what I want to ask you is this, maybe two things. One, do you see a difference? Do you see between the people who say, whatever, Power BI, versus who go, whoa, this is interesting. Can you sometimes tell that just by walking into the place? I don't know, right? I mean, do you sometimes know already?
Definitely.
Tell me more. What are the signs? Who are the kind of people or companies who say, whatever, Power BI, we're okay, versus those who say, man, this is happening, let's do this?
Okay. First of all, my personal opinion, I see that the clients, the small companies in general, especially here in our market, based on my experience with them, they are not willing to take an extra step or let's name it as investment to upgrade to Power BI. No, خلاص, we know how to use Excel. It's fine for us.
Okay. Yeah.
Especially for companies like 50 employees or less. Okay. Mm-hmm. So they will not take this step. Yeah.
Okay.
Above that, they have too much working hours on reporting, on data analysis, on data gathering. So when you present Power BI on the right way, and show them what Power BI can do in one click, and how could Power BI reflect your real data as a live dashboard on your mobile, this will be a very key competitive edge you can focus on, and they will start convincing and asking for more. But you know something, based on my experience, I saw that eventually it will get back to the person itself. When the man in charge see how he is, you know, he feels like, I don't want to know more. We are the best. We don't need to learn anything in you. We don't need anyone like you or anyone else to make us better. So I will stick to Excel. But it depends on the organization, and it depends on the person in charge himself or herself.
That's true. That's true. I mean, I've seen and led a few, you know, kind of the ground up revolutions where, I mean, I was kind of the bottom of the ladder, but, you know, you kind of start using it and you influence other people and you can push that way. But I've also heard stories where they had support from kind of top management, and it goes very differently. And you're right, it does depend on the leader. I mean, I sometimes feel that some leaders sometimes, well, often, and you can't blame them, they're disconnected with what kind of the ground level troops are doing, right? I mean, they're disconnected from the fact that there's somebody's cranking out, somebody stayed late to, like, I don't know, 11, 12 in the night last night to generate this report for you. They just walk into the meeting, they see this PowerPoint, and, you know, I mean, they ask questions and the action items, everybody else is like jotting down the action items. So sometimes they're not connected with that. So that's really interesting, man. And that's certainly food for thought for me. I think what you said was, I'm not so sure about the 50% mark, small a bit, but I you know, it's interesting that you've seen that. But of course, one thing is true, that if you have experienced that pain, it's so easy to talk to those people. Like, I mean, you know, you start talking and you say, oh, you can do this, and they go, yes, you know, so that makes sense. But I wanted to take you back a little bit. So I know you're focused on running the Academy right now, but by background, you're an industrial engineer, right?
Yes, I am. Yes.
So a few questions there. I mean, did you ever have a chance to kind of apply Power BI in that role? Do you still have that opportunity? Are you maybe targeting that vertical with your training academy? What's the deal there?
See, if you allow me, I will drive a little bit out the track.
Sure. Yep. Your journey, man. Yeah. Take us along. We'll come along with you.
See, when I graduated as an industrial engineer, I started working in a professional career as a salesman for like five, almost 6 years. Then I I get the chance to start my own business and I decide to become a trainer. So that's why I open or I launch a training provider company.
Yeah.
After that, actually, you know, you started your own business and you take this shift from a full-time employee to a business owner, and you know how much it's stressful, it's challenging.
It's a whole world.
Yes, I think you totally understand this. And unfortunately, you know, you passed through some critical period of times when you have no cash flows or something. So I take a decision to take back a step to become an employee again, full time, and keep my business running.
Yeah.
To till my business reach a stable or steady state, then I can quit and get back again. Just to, you know, because I don't want to quit my business and I want to survive as long as I can. So I took this step. When I took this step, I shift my career to project management. And I work in project management since then. We're talking about like 3.5 years almost.
All right.
And I do use Power BI in project management, actually.
Nice.
Very, 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 very in deep, let's say. And it's very convenient.
Yeah.
It saves too much time for me, actually.
That's terrific. So you are a certified PMP. Tell me, so, you know, business, I will say that I found that there's no right path, right? I mean, thank you for sharing kind of your journey. I mean, I kind of quit my job, but yeah, there's no right path. You have to kind of make your own.
Yeah,
but what I want to ask you is, and maybe this will be a good note to end things on, is that what I feel is that me running my business, it can't be just about money. I mean, sure, that's there. You know, I definitely want to make money, but it can't be just about that, because I feel like there are so many ways to make money.
Yeah, sure. It's about your
passion
as well.
One of the easiest ones. Yeah. So tell me a little bit more about that. What do you get out of that? What drives you in continuing that in spite of these obstacles you've faced?
To you mean to proceed and continue on my business, right?
Yeah, this training academy. Yeah. What's under that? What's driving you forward?
Yeah, I got you. So basically, it is my motivation to come over these challenges. Basically, it's the same reason I start as a training provider. The same reason I launched my own business. First of all, I love to be a trainer.
Okay.
So I'm very young. So here in Jordan, you know, if you are like 10 years experience or less, you don't have the right to train, okay, to coach.
Yeah, that makes no sense. All right.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, this is the culture here. So I took a step to launch my own business academy. To train as much as I want. You know, I don't want someone to say to me, "Yeah, you can," or "No, you couldn't." This is the basic. I still have this motivation. Actually, my passion in training. I really feel very happy when I coach or train somebody. This is the first one. Second. You know, I don't like to feel you are managed by someone. Maybe this someone, maybe a good one or bad one, but eventually you don't have, you don't feel like you are secured. You know?
Tell me a little bit about the training. Is there a specific format that you like? I mean, do you like kind of teaching a class? Do you like working in a smaller group? Do you like working kind of one-on-one? And what are the kind of the moments that, you know, you go, whoa, this is awesome. So kind of the format you like, and what specifically in training is that you like? I mean, I don't know, the connection with students.
Regarding the format of training, actually, I don't mind whatever it is. I feel comfortable with.
Is there
I
one
don't
you
have.
enjoy more than the others?
Maybe let's say medium number of attendees or trainees will be the
Yeah,
best.
makes sense.
Okay, but I tried to be on stage for like 90 to 100 person attendee,
Yeah,
and I
yeah.
tried to be one to one.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I
Yeah.
think let's say 10 to 15. I feel this is the best for me.
Yeah.
Regarding the moments I love in training, actually, my best moments in training when I finish the class. And when the attendees come around you, like after 5, 10 minutes asking questions, or thank you for something, or can I do this, or what do you think about this? Actually, I love to guide my trainees. I love to give all I have to another one. I feel like I'm satisfied that I'm doing something.
Man, that is beautiful.
Thank you.
So you've probably heard me say this before. One of my students taught me this phrase, to teach is to learn twice. I know I'm going to go back and listen to this interview again because there was so much goodness in there. Thayer,
Thank
I
you.
can't
Thank you,
thank you
sir.
enough for your time,
Appreciate
for this
it.
conversation.
Appreciate it, Avi. Thank you very much.
All right, man.
Are you doing what you love? That's what makes Thayer a pioneer. If you would like to start on your journey to become a Power BI pioneer, then join us in the Learn Power BI family. There's information in the details below. Power on, my friend.